We have explained the statistics and history of cochlear implants before. It was pioneered by Dr. William House, and since then has undergone some upgrades in design and functionality. The later versions also allow the user to hear clearer and more accurate sounds, which is transmitted to the cochlear via the electrode array. This causes stimulation of the auditory nerve fiber by simulating the perceptions of different frequencies of sounds using more channels in the implant's electrode. Now, we will proceed to the next topic. Candidacy. Although institutional practices may vary, there are four main criteria for patient selection: functional, medical, audiometric, and linguistic. Functional. If a patient can still be helped by using the conventional hearing aid, he does not need the cochlear implant. Audiometric. The deafness should be more than 90 decibels and does not improve after 3 months of use of hearing aids. Medical. Some deformities of the inner ear anatomy may still allow for cochlear implants, but others, like Michelle aplasia, are a contraindication for cochlear implant. Linguistic. Does the patient start to lose hearing after or before the speech development? If she becomes deaf after she can speak, or postlingual deafness, then it will be manageable for her, because her speech center of the brain is already developed and she can immediately focus on her hearing loss treatment. An underdeveloped speech center of the brain directly affects the patient's ability to speak. That is why a congenital hearing loss is called prelingual deafness. That will leave the patient deaf-mute if not immediately treated. The risk of not being able to speak is certain, as hearing sound and voice are essential to the development of this part of the brain. Many countries run a screening program for congenital hearing loss to identify prelingual deafness as early as possible. The screening uses an otoacoustic emission test, and the suspected babies are further evaluated to be given a cochlear implant if needed. Hopefully, the hearing issue can be overcome as soon as possible, so it doesn't impede their speech development. Concerned countries and other organizations also have sponsored programs for cochlear implants to ensure the affected newborns can get them for free. For more extensive information on deafness in children, you can refer to our other video somewhere in the channel. The next part will explain the surgical procedure for cochlear implant, its complications, and treatments.